Yo, this is Nas chilling with my man Fernando of Fun X Radio. Y'all know what it is. Hip hop is dead, hip hop is live. Ask Nas, I'll let you know.
It was a wonderful show. I want to congratulate you on having a wonderful show. Really enjoyed it?
Yeah, I had a good time, yo. Okay. Yeah.
You're working on your 9th album. What kind of state of mind can we expect to hear on a new album?
You know, the state of mind now is hip hop is dead. It means freedom. It means, you know, break out of the chains of the way you've been thinking you're supposed to make music, the way you're supposed to be listening to music. Just, you know, pay attention to the culture, pay attention to what hip hop was all about in the beginning and why they fought for us to be here now. You know, it's just me giving my thanks to the pioneers of rap music. So the state of mind is hip hop is dead to create the awareness, you know.
Okay, and I also heard like you're busy with a reality show with your wife, Khalees. What was the reason that you wanted to do that? Because like in the public's eye, you're like a more conservative dude, like laid back in the cut. What was the reason you wanted to do a reality show?
Well, I didn't want to do it, you know what I mean? But I had to challenge it, you know what I mean? And say, you know, what's up, you know, like, could we shoot something that's less documentary style, but more like, not less reality show, more documentary style, you know, give people an inside of what I'm doing. A lot of people don't really get a chance to see how my day-to-day goes on the road or behind the scenes, and you know what I'm saying? It's nothing like, you know, waking up in the bed, like, runs house with his wife, and it's not like, you know, the reality show type of thing. It's, you know, just get a chance to see what's going on behind the scenes, get inside my world a little bit, you know what I mean?
That first when you came into the game, you was real like hungry, you really liked the whole like the energy to like start a new game, and then you broke the water, broke the ice, and then you saw that it was a real business. Did you like get disappointed with that?
Yeah, it's a really big disappointment, because the business is it kills the music, you know what I mean? And because the business is all set up to really destroy the artist, so you gotta really learn how to deal with that. You gotta be as good as a business as you are in music, you know what I mean? You gotta be best at everything you do, but the business definitely always gonna mess with the art, you know?
Okay, but the whole world, you shocked the whole world with the I Declare War concert. How did that feel for you? Cause like, joined forces with Jay-Z and just put the beef down. How did that feel? Was it hard for you as a lyricist? And
nah, it's just grown man business, you know, and we just did it for the next generation. Hopefully they can get on to it, because, you know, you got to be real about this, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, you can't dwell on the beef and forever. You can't, you know, a lot of cats are onto that now, and that's cool, because that's the new onto that, you know, and I respect them for fighting. But after some point, you know, when you grow in life, you got to go to the next phase. The next phase is not a physical fight with your with the homie on the block no more. The next phase is a bigger fight, you know what I'm saying? The bigger fight is what is the real test, and that's where we're at now. That's where I'm at.
Like, real Nas fans are always saying like, yeah, Nas sold his hip-hop ideals just to be commercially successful. How do you feel when your fans tell you like, make another Illmatic? How do you feel about that?
Not really nothing, you know. You gotta always balance your stuff. A lot of artists don't make it because they don't know how to be 100% real. You gotta balance it. You gotta be able to talk to the masses, and you gotta be able to talk to the block. So you gotta, if you can balance both of them, you can have a career, you can have a legacy. You won't have to look for ideas every on your third album. People are questioning you because you run out of gimmicks, you know what I mean? You just got to stick to what you do best and just translate your word to the masses across the world and the block, and that's what I do.
Yeah. Thank you for your time.